for mom.
Oh, man. Really?
Get a handkerchief.
It is. It is. Here we go.
And now you know. Did we miss it?
No, I'm going to read it to you here in a second.
Dog's asking him something.
Okay, it says, babe, it's simple. Without life with you doesn't make sense. See you soon at the altar. So happy. Love to have you in my life, your wife.
Don't get it.
Congratulations.
By that time, I'm about to.
We were so meant to be late.
Oh, Vincent. What a grand and a sacred celebration. For the Bible declares, husband, love your wife as Christ has loved the church. I also make a declaration, Erica, for you also, to submit to your own husband. To be under his protection, to be under his guidance, to be under his leadership as he sees. And follow after Christ. Dear beloved, we are gathered together here in the eyesight of God, in the face of this company, to join together this man, Vincent, and this woman, Erica, in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God, signifying unto us the mystical union that is between Christ and his church, which holy state Christ adorned and beautified with his presence and his first miracle that he wrought in Cana of Galilee, and is commanded by St. Paul to be an honorable among all, and therefore it is not by any to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, soberly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy state, these two persons present come now to be joined. If any can show just cause why they may not lawfully be joined together, let them now speak, or else hereafter forever hold their peace. I require to charge you both, as ye will answer at the dreadful day of judgment, when the secrets of our hearts shall be disclosed, that if either of you know any impediment why ye may not be lawfully joined together in matrimony, ye do now confess it, for be ye well assured that if any persons are joined together otherwise than as God's word do allow, your marriage is not lawful. Vincent, would thou have this woman to be thy wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy state of matrimony? Will thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her so long as we both shall live?
I do. I will.
Harold, wilt thou have this man to thy wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in holy estate of matrimony? Will thou love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsake all others, keep thee only unto him, so as long as ye both shall live? I, Vincent, take thee, Erica.
Take thee, Erica.
To my wedded wife.
To my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poor.
For richer or poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish. Till death do us part.
According to God's ordinance.
To God's ordinance.
And thereto I plight thee my troth. And thereto I plight thee my troth.
And to there and plight thee my troth.
Yeah, you see. my wedded husband shall have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer. In sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, to death do us harm. According to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I give thee my trust. Bless, O Lord, this ring, that he who gives it and she who wears it may abide thy peace and continue in thy favor until life end. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Bless, O Lord, this ring that he who gives it and she who wears it, he who wears it, may abide in thy peace and continue in thy favor until life's end. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. O Lord God, how excellent is your name. We have come together to witness this holy and sacred ceremony in which Vincent and Erica is seeking to do your will. So God, we pray over them, God. We speak blessings, we speak life, we speak prosperity. God, we speak the word that your word will not return unto you both. We speak longevity again, God. We love you and we thank for what you're going to do with this circle of marriage. We ask you now, God, to keep them forever is our prayer. In Jesus' name, we do pray. Amen.
Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand. I present to you Mr. Vincent and Erica DeWalt.
Thank you.
mother of the bride. Isn't she beautiful? Mrs. Cornelia Taylor, auntie of the bride. Our other honorary aunt is Mrs. Bonita English. Maid of honor, Mrs. Natasha Henry. Bridesmaid, Mrs. Pamela Law. Bridesmaid, Angela Johnson. Best maid, Lance Watson. All right, now, okay. You guys go ahead now. Groomsman, Mr. Jerry Clark. Law.
Yes.
Our hostess for the evening was none other than Mrs. Sade Law. And our ushers, Willie Anthony Hunter.
Woo!
Usher Daniel Ryan Law.
Good evening.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the perfect couple for such a perfect day. It has been my pleasure to not only meet these two people, but to serve them as well. One of the sweetest people that I've met in a very long time. I love both of you, and I want to thank you for allowing me to be a part of this celebration. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please put your hands together for Mr. and Mrs. Erica and Vincent DeWalt.
free, kick back now. I don't even know how to act now. Hit the clubs, niggas getting naked before I sat down. See a ball, I'm running stacked, dollar shack now. See a push a button to let the roof on the back down. I'm on the road, gonna show the room back down. Mississippi, Philly, Albuquerque, the chat time. Crowd yelling, bring them out, egg them out. I'm a hot girl yelling, bring them out, egg them out. Would enjoy their first dance.
Next up, we got the mother-in-law and the groom. Oh yeah, I'm so glad. Oh, I like that right there, man. Oh, I like that right there.
So at this time, we're going to go ahead and open up to get ready to serve the food. Wait a minute, let me make sure. Wait a minute, they ain't in staff.
Prestige, we ready for you guys.
Oh, they ready. Prestige is ready. I think we all ready to get to our favorite part of the reception. That's the food.
That's Prestige Catering.
Y'all been served by Prestige Catering? So far, so good.
I'm going to take the rest of them.
We're going to serenade you with a little R&B as you do that part. So
I don't know what the instructions are. I'm sure the waiting party will go serve themselves first.
Biscuits. Thank you.
How are you, sir?
All right.
Who made the food? You did? You made all the food?
I'm just a servant. I can't take the credit.
Big on family, you know, so I tell you what happened is I had an opportunity to watch Erica and Vincent over a period of time. I watched them go through some good times, and I watched them go through a couple of rough patches where they had to figure things out and work through. And I knew by how they handled the hard times, how they would be if they got together for the good times. Right? Because if anyone who's married in the room or anyone who's dated someone for a long time knows, it's not the good times that defines the marriage, it's what you do in the bad times that actually makes you turn into a marriage. Because it's easy to get married, it's hard as hell to stay married, right? So as I watch these two develop, and as I watch them navigate life's relationships and all the things and the temptations that come with it, I said, okay, Vincent, he was happy, he seemed proud, he seemed kind of brand new about it, he was excited. He was solid gold 2 a.m. in the morning excited. You know, and if you live down in Mobile, you know what solid gold means. 2 a.m. in the morning, we already know, right? Ain't nothing good happening at 2 a.m. in the morning. So he was a little excited, but I said, he's enthusiastic. So we'll see how he pans out. So the time comes and we talk, and you know, recently we had my grandfather's 100th birthday, and Vincent was there. And the thing I noticed the most is, you know, when me and my wife, we have this chemistry that we work as not just soulmates, we work as a team. And I can tell when Vincent talks about Erica to me and when Erica talks to me about Vincent, there's a shine in his eye. There's a shine in her eye. She's smiling the whole time. She can barely contain the smile because she's so happy. Now, the beauty of it is, in order to find that happiness, you have to go into some sorrows.
obviously I grew up with my sister, you know, and I've been through thick and thin with her, you know, and then we get to talking about Vincent and his family and what he means to them. I'm happy for them both because I think it's important for you in life to find, you know, not just a soulmate, but you need to find a partner. You need to find somebody that you can walk down the street with that you know that in the tough times they're there with you and in the good times they're there with you as well. But no matter what happens, they're there to help you and support you and kind of keep you on the right path and in the right focus and keep you humble, but always hungry for what you want in life. You know, and that's what they have right now.
So now, how do you feel about the wedding?
Oh my goodness.
Tell me.
I'm very excited. I'm here. It's nice. It's like a little vacation from California. So, happy wedding day. Whose day is it today?
I don't know.
Oh my goodness. Happy wedding day. We love you. Say hi.
Hi.
I'm so bad. Me too.
I would love to say to Erica, best wishes for a beautiful marriage. And hoping all the best for and best throughout.
Erica, I had no idea when I volunteered to help Nettie with the wedding that it was someone that I knew. And we go over 25 years back, and she's still pretty today as she was the day I met her at Gator. Love you, girl.
Congratulations to the bride, you know, everybody.
And so we're super excited for you guys, and can't wait to see it all happen and
celebrate with you afterwards.
We got a brand new dance. You got a new
Until it starts again. Oh, and